to see your face. We welcome your spirit. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. Come like a flame of fire, a mighty rushing wind. Our praise will in the heavens fall afresh again. Come like a flame of fire, a mighty rushing wind. Our praise will in the heavens fall afresh again. Oh, come fall afresh again. fall afresh again. Come fall afresh again. Come fall afresh again. We are ready. We are ready. Come fall afresh again. Glory cloud, we are ready. Show us your glory. Show us your glory. We are ready. We are hungry. We are hungry. We are hungry. We love to see your glory. Show us your glory. Come in power. Show us your glory. We want to see your glory. Release the fullness of your Holy Spirit. We want to see your glory here. Come in power. Come in power. Come like fire. Come like wind. Come like oil. Show us your glory. 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 Show us your glory.
Pour your spirit out. righteousness, peace, and joy overflowing, 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 overflowing. Righteousness, peace, and joy.
He is righteousness, peace, and joy. He is righteousness, peace, and joy. Oh, this is your Savior, your high priest forever. Righteousness, peace, and joy. He is righteousness, peace, and joy. Just look at him. Just look at him. Fix your eyes on him. Righteousness, peace, and joy. Behold the Lamb. This is your Savior. Oh, this is your Savior. Righteousness, peace, and joy. This is your Savior. This is our Savior. Look at him. Look at him. This is our Savior. Look at him. This is our Savior. Look at him. Look at him. This is our Savior. Would you look at him? This is our Savior. Look at him, look at him. This is our Savior. Look at him. This is our Savior. Look at him, look at him. This is our Savior. Fix your eyes. This is our Savior. Look at him, look at him. This is our Savior. This is our Savior. Look at him. Fix your eyes on him. Everything you need is found in Him. Oh, all that you need is found in Him. Behold the Lamb. Oh, we behold the Lamb. We fix our eyes on you. We make it all about you. This is all about you. Oh, this is all about you, King Jesus. Oh, this is all about you, King Jesus. Oh, this is all about you. It's all about you.
Hearing that song, just keep playing.
Wait a minute, Jesus. Stay with me a while. Wait a minute, Jesus. Stay with me.
Psalm 92 says, "But my horn you have exalted like a wild ox, for I have been anointed with fresh oil, and my eye also has seen my desire on my enemies. My ears hear my desire on the wicked who rise up against me. The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those who are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. They shall still bear fruit in old age. They shall be fresh and flourishing to declare that the Lord is upright. He is my rock, and there is no unrighteousness in him." You've been anointed with fresh oil. There's fresh oil in the house tonight. You've been anointed with strength like a wild ox, like a wild, strong ox. I'm gonna read something to you. It's fixing to spill over here. It's fixing to spill over here. Glory to God. Praise the name of the Lord. Woo!
Pray a minute, Jesus. Stay with me a while.
Psalm 144 says, "Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle." Woo! He trains my hands for war and prepares my fingers for battle, for the detail, for the small things. Look at your hands. What have you got in your hands tonight? What did you bring with you? Jesus said, when all these people were hungry, and he'd been teaching for a long time, all these people were hungry, and the disciples said, "Should we send them away so they can eat and come back?" He said, "What do you got in your hands? You give them something to eat. What do you got in your hand right now? What has he prepared you with? What has he prepared you for?" He's prepared you for battle. He's prepared your hands for war. Now, in the old covenant, they would kill nations. They would kill bloodlines that were perverted and evil and wicked. But in the New Testament, we don't wrestle with flesh and blood. We war against principalities and powers and mights and dominions. And we displace them with the kingdom of God on earth as it is in heaven. Glory to God. Our hands are prepared for war. What does that mean? That means whenever you come up against the enemy, you are prepared right now. Why? Because you've been anointed with fresh oil like a wild ox. Like a wild ox. Like a wild ox. That's not very flattering, I know. But the strength of an ox. I saw a video of a person standing next to an ox, and it was taller than them. And I was like, "Potter, look, this is an ox." He's anointed us with fresh oil. We're bigger than we realize. We're bigger on the inside than the world is on the outside. And he's prepared our hands for war. And when the enemy comes at your door, boom, you cast the devil out. You heal the sick. You raise the dead. You cleanse the leper. We're not waiting for the glory. The glory's here. Not waiting for the anointing. We've been anointed, past tense, with a fresh oil, fresh anointing. Some of you are due for an oil change. You are. You're due for an oil change. There's inventions being released from heaven. There's creativity being released from heaven. There's finances being released from heaven. It's all in the glory. He supplies all of our needs according to the riches in glory. In glory, it's joy. It's in the glory. The glory is here. The glory is coming. The glory is expanding. The glory is magnifying. It's multiplying. It's exploding all over this region. The glory is here. God, show us your glory. Come on. Woo! Glory to God. Glory to God. Woo! You ever get hunger pains? You ever get just that hollowness in your gut where you're just like, I'm hungry. What do? I'm going to go find me something to eat. I'm going to go find me something to eat. I'm going to find something to eat. I'm going to find something to fill that hunger, that crave. We named this whole meeting after a crave. If you've ever craved something, I mean, you crave it, you're aching for it. What do? You go and find something to fill that crave, that which you're craving for. If you ever been around someone that was pregnant and they have cravings when they're pregnant, and if you're not the one craving, you think you got all the time in the world to get that thing that they're craving. But there is a righteous anger. There is a righteous passion for that which you crave for. And you will move toward that thing that you crave for. We crave for the Holy Ghost. We crave for glory. We crave for Jesus to manifest himself. We crave for the angelic host to manifest themselves in our midst. Romans 1:11, for I long to see you that I may impart to you some spiritual gift so that you may be established, that is, that I may be encouraged together with you by the mutual faith of both you and me. Glory to God. Glory to God. There is an impartation that you have in you to impart to someone else. You'll get frustrated if you can't spend it, if you can't give it, if you can't demonstrate it. It's this gospel that we're going into is not one with man's wisdom and intellectualism, but in boldness and power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost. No one's going to be thrilled with your intellect, but they will be awestruck by the bold demonstrations of the Holy Ghost that comes through your life that you impart to others. It doesn't always come with the laying on of hands. Sometimes it just comes in the conversation. Sometimes it comes in just standing there and saying it's going to be okay. Sometimes it just shows up in the grocery store when you're in line, or the restaurant when you're, and they begin to tell you their life story, or they begin to weep, or they begin to tear up, or they begin to break down. And you are sovereignly, divinely planted as the solution to what they're going through. You may have come here tonight that you need a healing in your body, a miracle in your life, a breakthrough in your finances, a breakthrough in your mindset. You need things broken off of you. You need things erased from you. Some of you need to become invisible to the enemy. You need to become invisible to your past. People looking for things, dirt on you, you need to become invisible. Just gone. Gone from the internet, gone from your records, they can't find any dirt on you. God has already cast all your past into the sea of forgetfulness. That needs to happen naturally. I don't know why. I've never done this before. Always want people to be seen. But tonight, for some reason, there may be just one person in here. Maybe you know somebody that needs to become invisible. When they were going to throw Jesus over the cliff after his first message, they took him to the brow of the hill wanting to throw him off the cliff. It says he walked right through the crowd. He became invisible. And he went his way. Things are going to start going your way at 7:46 p.m. on a Wednesday night. Things have just turned for your favor. And they're going to start going your way. Not the devil's way. Not the world's way. Not those that are looking for you's way. You are invisible. I'm not even going to have you raise your hand. You just say, Lord, make me invisible to those that seek my harm. Hide me not out of sight, but out of reach. Set me high upon a rock, far above all my enemies, so that they can see me eating in their presence. At the table of blessing. There is an atmosphere of favor. An atmosphere of favor that just filled the room. Does anybody need favor? Unusual favor. Anybody want? I mean, I don't know why you wouldn't want it. Favor. You say, well, I already got favor. I get all that. I get that. But sometimes you need unusual favor. You need a break. Your application needs to float on top. Your promotion needs to be above everybody else's. You need finances to come to you that you didn't earn, that you didn't work for. You need breakthrough in mindsets and capacities to believe bigger than you've ever believed before. Unusual favor. Unusual favor. They say things like, we don't usually do this, but we're going to go ahead and give you the bonus. We're going to give you the raise. We're going to give you the increase. We're going to hire you, even though there's more qualified. We're going to give you the break. We're going to dismiss this charge. We're going to dismiss this debt. We're going to dismiss this thing that's against you. It's all getting dumped in the sea of forgetfulness. The enemy comes to accuse you before God. He said, I don't remember. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't remember that at all. I don't remember that at all. You know how you receive that? You do that for others. You forget it. Forget what they've done to you. Just forget it. When it comes up in your mind, because the enemy's putting it there, cast it down like lightning, like Jesus did the devil. I saw Satan fall like lightning. I saw that thought fall like lightning. Woo! If you're here tonight and you need a healing in your body, you need a miracle in your body, in your life. You need a breakthrough in your mind. You need your soul refreshed. Maybe you just need a fresh anointing. If you would, just where you're sitting or standing, just raise your hand. Just raise your hand. There's people all over the room, their hands raised. Look around you. If there's someone near you, two or three, four or five of you, gather around them. Declare the goodness of God over them. Ask them what's going on and declare the goodness of God over them. Impart to them that which you have. Let it come through your hands. Good reports of people being released from their treatments, cancers being healed, tumors disappearing, long-term sicknesses being removed from their life, chronic pain being healed. Glory to God. Financial breakthrough coming to people's lives. Relational healing in families. Prodigals are coming home. Prodigals are coming home. Glory to God. Prodigals are coming home. If you still got prodigals out there or they're just not on fire for God, be encouraged because it's working. They're coming. They're coming home. They're coming home. They're coming back. They're coming back, not the way they were. They're coming back on fire for God. Glory to God. Then we'll be like those that dream. Then our mouths will be filled with laughter and our tongues with singing, saying, He has done great things for us. He has done great things for me. He has done great things for us. Glory to God. Breakthrough. Breakthrough. Breakthrough is here. Breakthrough is coming. Glory to God. Glory to God. Sunday there was a person that had an open vision of angels standing behind Josh when he was preaching and teaching and flowing with the Holy Ghost. First vision they had ever had. They saw angels, big angels, up on the platform standing behind Josh. They're here whether you can see them or not. They're here. But it's fun to see them. It's fun to see them. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. Glory to God. Glory to God. All over this room. They're waiting. They're waiting. They're waiting. They're ministering spirits to the saints of God. You are a saint of God. You may not feel like you're a saint, but you are a saint of God. Glory to God. Give your angels an assignment. Give give your angels an assignment. I know some don't believe that you can talk and command angels. That's fine. They can come work for me. Give them an assignment. Give them something to do. There's angels that gather. What do you need them to gather? What do you need them to gather? Maybe you don't need them to gather anything. Maybe you got everything you need. Give them an assignment. Say, hey, go gather that which I need that comes from heaven.
Yes. Yes.
Praise
yes.
God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God. Glory to God. Glory to God. How about go and gather those that hunger and thirst for God, but they don't know it. They don't know what they're hungering for. And they're feeding their flesh with drugs and alcohol and lust and all that stuff. But they're really hungry for spiritual things. Angels, go and gather those in that are hungry for the glory. Bring them from the four corners of this county, in this region, our sphere of influence. Glory to God. Glory to God. It's working. It's working, even when you can't see it. That's when your faith is working best. It's when your faith is working its best. Yeah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. God. Glory to God. Changed direction. Changed a direction in your life. Takes a bit. Reorient yourself. Get your bearings. What that looks like.
146. Change directions for the good. We weren't going bad. It was just, this is. We know the voice of the good shepherd. And the voice of a stranger we will not follow. Those that are the sons and daughters of God are led by the Spirit of God. This whole earth is groaning. Groaning. Sons and daughters of God to be revealed. Ready or not, here he comes. Ready or not, here he comes. You're ready. I'm ready. Welcome to stay around. You go as well. Glory to God.